The Winchester Model 12 is one of the most popular pump shotguns ever made. Let's take a look at it from the inside out. Over 2 million Model 12s were produced before production ended in 1980. The Model 12 was originally known as the Model 1912 and was first offered only in 20 gauge, followed by the 12, 16, and 28 gauges. It was the first hammerless pump action shotgun produced by Winchester, as the Model 1897 had an external hammer. Let's take a look at how a Model 12 works. A cutaway will let us see inside the gun as it operates. The factories often use cutaways as sales tools to show how a specific model operated. I'm starting with a standard field grade Model 12. The stock on this gun has been refinished, and the barrel has quite a bulge near the end, so it certainly isn't a collector's item. I begin by completely disassembling the gun. The lock pin in the front of the magazine tube is pushed in, rotated 90 degrees. The action slide handle is pushed to the front, pulling the magazine tube along with it. The complete barrel assembly is then rotated 90 degrees and removed from the receiver. The guard screw is removed and the trigger guard assembly is pulled from the receiver. With the breech bolt fully forward, I can remove the ejector. Now the breech bolt comes out, as well as the cartridge cutoff. The bolt is completely disassembled, as well as the fore-end assembly. A spanner wrench removes the nut that holds the fore-end wood. With the barrel back on the receiver, the areas to be cut away are marked. I want to remove enough metal to clearly see the inside workings. The receiver is fixtured securely in the mill, making sure it's level. Then it takes several slow, shallow passes with a carbide end mill. With the machining work on the receiver complete, I make the appropriate cuts in the bolt, as well as the trigger guard. This cut will allow us to see how the nose of the trigger engages with the hammer. With all the cuts made, I deburr the edges with a small file. Painting the parts different colors makes them really stand out. With the cutaway complete, let's see how a Model 12 works. First, I load dummy rounds in the magazine tube. The magazine plug prevents a third round from being loaded. This shell is held in place by a small tab on the bottom of the bolt. A raised area on the safety prevents the trigger from being pulled when the safety is engaged. Pushing the safety to the fire position provides clearance for the trigger to move and disengage from the hammer notch. The hammer goes forward, hitting the firing pin, causing the gun to fire. As the hammer moves, it puts downward spring pressure on the slide lock. However, this compression spring around the magazine tube holds the slide lock in position until the recoil of firing causes the fore end to move forward, releasing the slide lock. The slide lock can also be released without pulling the trigger by using the button behind the trigger guard. After the gun is fired, the slide handle is pulled rearward. This causes the bolt to begin its rearward travel. The extractor holds the rim of the fired shell, pulling it from the chamber. As the bolt continues to the rear, it recocks the hammer. Once the fired shell is clear of the chamber, it's kicked out by the ejector. Pushing the slide handle forward loads a new round into the chamber and locks the bolt closed. As the fired shell is being ejected, the magazine spring has forced the next shell into position. A locking lug on the top rear of the bolt engages a recess in the receiver. As the slide is moved rearward, the locking lug drops out of its recess, allowing the bolt to move rearward. Then, as the bolt moves forward, the locking lug moves back up into its recess, completing the cycle.